last week, in part because of a hand injury and in part due to some struggles during the Sooners' upset loss to Baylor. Still, Lincoln Riley is going back to his true freshman quarterback for tomorrow's game against Iowa State, even though his Heisman buzz has taken a hit as Oklahoma has fallen out of college football playoff contention for now. So, Shannon, was he overhyped?
Of course he was. But I never got behind Spencer Rattler either. Skip believes he was going to win the Heisman. Todd McShay.
Well, he was the favorite to win the Heisman.
Todd McShay and Mel Kiper had him as the number one overall pick.
I think Mel had him two, but Todd had him one, and it was close.
And now he's going to be in transfer portal.
I think you're right, unless what happened last week changed that. Right. But go ahead.
But when you look at Skip, you look at, first of all, I give the guy credit that what he did against Texas. But come to find out, Texas is a bad football team. Texas just lost to Kansas. Now, we gave him credit. Oh, did you see that? You had never seen a play. And I hadn't. Never seen an offensive player take the ball from a teammate and go get a first down. But my question to you was, Skip, why were you in that situation with Kansas anyway? That's Kansas football, not Kansas basketball. Mm-hmm. So the mere fact that you had 0 points against a perennial underperforming Kansas football team lets you know, because you gave him all this credit for coming back, but what about the blame for being in this position anyway? So he was overhyped. He's not going to win the Heisman. You know who's going to win the Heisman. Don't we, Skip?
I don't.
You do know. He plays for Alabama.
Oh, okay.
Oh, my.
Are you finished?
I'm finished.
I'm going to start, and I'm going to unleash. And I will be the first to admit I was born and bred a University of Oklahoma fan, so maybe I have zero objectivity about this. Uh-huh. But I'm not sure I will ever recover from the decision that my coach, Lincoln Riley, made late in the third quarter at Baylor the other day.
Yeah.
Lincoln Riley saved our season by having the guts to go with this young man, Caleb Williams, in the second half against Texas when we were in trouble, and he lit up Texas. And I don't care how bad Texas is against everybody else. They're not bad against Oklahoma because it is as arch a rivalry as you will find in college football. And then Lincoln Riley turned right around and wrecked our playoff chances by going back to Spencer Rattler late in the third quarter the other day at Baylor with the score 10-7 Baylor. 10-7. Yeah. And when you say overhyped, a number of the national commentators, starting with Kirk Herbstreit, had mentioned the possibility, discussed realistically the possibility this kid was going to climb right into and maybe to the top of the Heisman race.
Never,
because he came into the Baylor game with 14 touchdowns and one interception and a QBR in just 3.5 games of 96 on a scale of 0 to 100. And to boot, he had 4 rushing touchdowns. And if we could see the pregame sound for our man Reggie Bush on our Big Noon pregame show, this was last Saturday at Baylor, if we could see what he said about my man Caleb Williams before the game and his prediction.
Mid-November, I feel like if Oklahoma's going to win this game, Caleb Williams is going to have a Heisman moment, because they're going to have to fight hard to get this win today. They're going to fight. They're going to have to fight for 60 minutes, Coach. This is going to be the best defense that they've seen, which is going to cause some problems for the Oklahoma offense. And then they can also score points on defense. So Caleb Williams is going to have to be really good today, and I think he'll have his Heisman moment if they win.
Reggie Bush, former Heisman winner, said Heisman moment. I was right there with our man Reggie Bush, because I thought this was the game, and then followed by an Iowa State game and an at Oklahoma State game and a Big 12 championship game in which he was about to take off and go win the Heisman Trophy as a true freshman. And what happened in the first half, he got off to a shaky start, because Baylor is really good, especially at home against us. They have a tradition of playing the hell out of us in Waco.
Okay.
And in the first half, Caleb suffered 3 drops. They were 3 very catchable passes by Drake Stoops, the first one, and Marvin Mims twice. And then our field goal kicker, Gabe Berkich, who's maybe as good as anybody in the country, missed 2 in the first half, or maybe we would have been leading 13-10 late in the third quarter when he went back to Spencer Rattler. What does Lincoln Riley see in Spencer? Well, he raised him from a baby. It's like one of his own. It's like a son of his.
Yeah.
And he would never publicly embrace or endorse Caleb Williams. And I don't know why. In part because
he put
him
in the game, okay, Skip.
But he did not want Spencer to he wants to keep Spencer Rattler there, doesn't want him to transfer. So I think he was just edging toward, I gotta go back to him, which is insanity to me because this kid had already proven to be a clutch fourth quarter playmaker. You blew the game when you went to Spencer Rattler.
Can I ask you a question? Why would you, if Caleb Williams is what you says he is.
He is.
Okay, yes. Why would you care if Spencer Rattler's transferred?
Well, I don't care, but I think Lincoln Riley has never bought into, I don't know why, because he would never say, remember the play at Kansas that you talk about? You want to talk about a play from a true freshman?
He said it was an yeah. He said it was
Can we see that real quick? This is where you're again, Kansas got upset fever and the game's still close. It's a 4th-and-1. And he goes and takes the ball away from Kenny Brooks and takes it himself. Says, well, if you can't get the first down, I'll go get the first down. And you admit it, you've never seen anything
right.
like it.
Yeah.
I've never seen anything.
It was a great play.
What did the coach say after the game? He credited the veteran running back, Kennedy Brooks. That was all Kennedy's choice. You know, yeah. that was his decision.
Let the ball go.
Okay, he let the ball go. Baloney, he did. And baloney on this decision. So Spencer Rattler goes back in the game, and I'm no fan, as I told you from the start. I didn't like what I was seeing. And he immediately underthrows a ball that was pass interference, should have been called, but then they just fizzle out. They go quickly out, and the defense lost all of its swagger, all of its confidence.
Defense ain't never had no swagger.
Okay, it did, because it immediately, it's 10-7 at that point at Baylor, and immediately they break a 75-yard run, and the game goes haywire. It goes crazy. And then all of a sudden, and again, he did get his hand stepped on in the first half, late in the first half, but we can see the play. Tell me you don't look like this run. This kid can really move. Watch him make the Baylor Bear miss here. Watch this little play here. Whoops. No, thank you very much. And as he goes out of bounds, he gets his hand stepped on, his passing hand stepped on. Did it really bother him? Well, it couldn't have bothered him that much because he put him back in the game once the game was lost and the playoff hopes were all lost. He puts him back in the game late. Here it is again. And if we just see one pass that he threw late to Jaden Hazelwood, he just goes, bombs away, goes right back in the game. So I guess his hand was just fine here late in the game because he just says, watch this. Hey, you want to talk about a cannon? He's got a bazooka. He's got it all. My eye tests would tell me he's the best player in college football.
No, he's not even
and
close.
You yanked him?
So I'm just
you
trying.
You yanked him for Spencer Rattler?
So,
what are you
okay,
doing
well,
in a 10-7 game?
Well, help me understand. How is he going to vault past the kid from Alabama, the kid from Ohio State, the kid from Pittsburgh, the kid from Ole Miss?
14 touchdowns to one interception. QBR of 96, 4 rushing touchdowns. Here he came. If he stayed right on that path, if you'd let him finish and have a Heisman moment in this
Skip,
fourth
Bryce
quarter.
Young has 33 touchdowns with 3 picks on the number 2 team in the country.
Yep. Reggie was on the bandwagon, and so was I.
I get on.
And our man Lincoln Riley ran it right off the road.
So you like 14-1. As opposed to 33-3 in the second spot.
Well, he had 4 more games to go.
How many? You think Alabama done playing?
Best player in college football is that kid right now.
No, he's not.
Yep.
Well, how you not on the field?
Well, please ask my coach that because I lost like 10 years on my life just watching that happen.
Skip, you know Oklahoma do this to you every year. You told me he was better than Kyler Murray. That man can't carry Kyler Murray in a pitcher and a bucket of water. You know that.
He's a true freshman.
I don't care if he was a fifth-year senior. He's never going to be better than Kyler Murray.
Much bigger arm, much bigger body. Sorry.
He can't do what Kyler did, Skip. I guarantee you, Kyler.
I love Kyler Murray.
I guarantee you, Kyler Murray wouldn't have lost that game. Kyler Murray wasn't gonna lose that game.
Well, would he have gotten yanked?
Hey,
yeah. He would have if he gotten yanked.
Kyler Murray would have started from opening the bell. Kyler Murray would have started from opening the bell.
Did he ever yank Baker Mayfield in favor of Kyler Murray?
Nope. No. Hold on.
Nope.
Skip.
Stop it.
Really?
All right, excited to see what he does tomorrow, but moving on, should we expect great things from Cam this weekend against his former coach? We'll have the latest next. Brady was found to be the most marketable player in the NFL, but some people were caught off guard that Odell Beckham Jr. came in second place on the list. OBJ obviously hasn't had nearly as much on-field success as Brady, but still has a big internet following dating back to the catch in his rookie year. So, Shannon, how do you explain Odell being second to Brady?
I was surprised, but when you look at the metrics in which they use, social media following had a big deal.
Yep.
He's the most followed player on IG, 14.7 million. Brady is next at 10.4. So he's 4.3 million more followers. He has 2 million more followers on Twitter than Tom Brady. Skip, I mean, you know, the catch, the personality, the outgoingness, the hair. There's a lot. Like I said, Skip, because he hadn't been that elite receiver since he left New York. So that's been 3 years ago.
Yep.
So normally when you look at the guy, and normally this is a quarterback, Skip. Quarterbacks are normally the face of the team. You see the guys up there. Brady's number one.
Yep.
And you have Rodgers. You have Wilson. You have Mahomes. So I was shocked that it was Odell.